Hi, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to prepare for a CSRF attack. Websites and web applications are vulnerable to malware, spam, and other attacks like cross-site request forgery attacks. CSRF attacks are particularly troubling because they can occur without the user's knowledge. They're also difficult for a developer or website owner to detect because the malicious requests appear highly similar to genuine requests. This video explores the steps you can take to prepare for a CSRF attack. But before we get started, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what is a CSRF attack? A CSRF attack tricks an authenticated user into performing unintended actions by submitting malicious requests without them realizing it. Typically, a CSRF attack involves state-changing requests because the attacker doesn't receive a response. Examples of such requests include deleting a record, changing a password, purchasing a product, or sending a message. These can all occur without the user's knowledge. The malicious attacker typically uses social engineering to send an unsuspecting user a link through chat or email. When the user clicks the link, it executes the commands the attacker sets. For instance, clicking on a link can transfer funds from a user's account, or it can change a user's email address, preventing them from regaining account access. Getting the user to initiate a state-changing request while logged in is the first and most crucial step in a CSRF attack. With CSRF attacks, the attacker aims to get an authenticated user to unknowingly submit a malicious web request to a website or web application. These requests can consist of cookies, URL parameters, and other data types that appear normal to the user. For a CSRF attack to be successful, the following conditions must occur. An authenticated user must be logged into a web application that uses cookies for session management. An attacker must create a state-changing forged request. Genuine requests handled by the target server should not contain unpredictable parameters. For instance, the whole request should not expect a password as a parameter for verification purposes before initiating the state-changing request. The most common method of completing CSRF attacks is using cookies in applications with a weak same-site cookie policy. Web browsers include cookies automatically and often anonymously, and they save cookies used by a domain in any web request the user sends to that domain. Same-site cookie policy defines how the browser in cross-site browsing context treats the cookie. If set to strict, the cookie isn't shared in cross-site browsing context, preventing CSRF attacks. The browser attaches the cookie in all cross-site context if it's set to none. This leaves the application vulnerable to CSRF attacks. When a user unknowingly submits a malicious request through a web browser, the saved cookies cause the request to appear legitimate to the server. The server then responds to the request by changing the user's account, changing the session state, or returning the requested data. There are several methods to prevent and drastically mitigate potential CSRF attacks on your website or web application, including using CSRF tokens, using the refer header, choosing a security-focused hosting solution like Kinsta. A CSRF secure website assigns each session a unique token and shares it with the server side and the client browser. Whenever a browser sends a sensitive request, the server expects it to contain the assigned CSRF token. If it has the wrong token, the server drops it. The CSRF token isn't stored in session cookies on the client's browser for security purposes. Although CSRF tokens are an excellent security measure, this method isn't attack-proof. Some of the vulnerabilities accompanying CSRF tokens include validation bypass. Some applications skip the verification step if they don't find a token. If an attacker gains access to code that contains a token, they can remove that token and successfully execute a CSRF attack. So, a valid request to a server looks like this. An attacker needs only to remove the token and send it like this to execute the attack. Pooled tokens. Some applications maintain a pool of tokens to validate user sessions instead of designating a specific token to a session. An attacker only needs to obtain one of the tokens already in the pool to impersonate any of the site's users. An attacker can log into an application using their account to obtain a token, such as. And since the tokens are pooled, the attacker can copy and use that same token to log in to a different user's account, as you will use it again. CSRFs can be a token copied to the cookie. Some applications will copy the parameters related to a token into a user's cookie. If an attacker gains access to such a cookie, they can easily create another cookie, place it in a browser, and execute a CSRF attack. So an attacker can log in to an application using their account and open the cookie file to see the following. They can then use this information to create another cookie to complete the attack. Invalid tokens. Some applications don't match CSRF tokens to a user session. In such cases, an attacker can genuinely log into a session, obtain a CSRF token, and use it to orchestrate a CSRF attack on a victim's session. Another strategy for preventing CSRF attacks is using the refer header. In HTTP, refer headers indicate the request's origin. They're typically used to perform analytics, optimization, and logging. You can also enable checking refer headers on the server side to prevent CSRF attacks. The server side checks the source origin of the request and determines the target origin of the request. If they match, then the request is allowed. If there's a mismatch, the server drops the request. Using refer headers is much easier than using tokens because it doesn't require individual user identification. Like CSRF tokens, refer headers have some significant vulnerabilities. First, refer headers aren't mandatory, and some sites will send requests without them. If the CSRF doesn't have the policy to handle requests without headers, attackers can use headerless requests to execute state-changing attacks. Additionally, this method has become less effective with the recent introduction of the referrer policy. This specification prevents URL leakage to other domains, giving users more control over the information in the refer header. They can choose to expose part of the refer header information or to disable it by adding a metadata tag on the HTML page, as shown here. This code removes the refer header for all requests from this page. Doing so makes it difficult for applications that rely on refer headers to prevent CSRF attacks from such a page. In addition to using the refer header and CSRF tokens, there is a third and way easier option. Choosing a secure hosting service like Kinsta for your websites and web application provides a much stronger and more secure barrier between attackers and your users. On top of critical security features such as automatic backups, two-factor authentication, and SFTP over SSH protocols, Kinsta's Cloudflare integration provides enterprise-level protection with IP-based and firewall protection. Specifically, Kinsta currently has around 60 custom firewall rules to help prevent malicious attacks and deal with severe unauthenticated vulnerabilities in plugins and themes, including specific ones that look for CSRF vulnerabilities. An unsecured website puts your customers and your reputation at risk. With Kinsta's Cloudflare integration, all the security features you need are built right into your plan at no additional cost. That's a monthly savings of around $200 per WordPress site. Learn more about these benefits, including DDoS protection, a more secure firewall, and more at kinsta.com/cloudflare integration. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.